Today I want to share with you about an exciting meal plan challenge, my favorite aprons, and more. Hi, sweet friends. I'm Mary, and welcome to Mary's Nest, where I teach traditional cooking skills for making nutrient-dense foods like bone broth, ferments, sourdough, and more. So if you enjoy learning about those things, consider subscribing to my channel, and don't forget to click on the little notification bell below. That'll let you know every time I upload a new video. Well, the first thing I want to talk to you about is Plan to Eat. And they're the meal planning service that allows you to collect your recipes from around the internet, then create your meal plans, and then create your grocery shopping list. And they're a great service. I love using them. They're having what they call a challenge. And I'm collaborating with them on this challenge because they do these periodically throughout the year. And the one that they're doing this fall is about traditional foods. And so they want to help people who are transitioning from a processed foods kitchen to a traditional foods kitchen. So they asked me to provide them with about 6 recipes that I felt were very useful and easy to people who were making that transition. And so some of the recipes that I shared with them were how to roast a chicken, how to make bone broth, how to make yogurt, how to make a sourdough starter, and then a sourdough bread, that's kind of a little extra one in there, and how to make sauerkraut, you know, an easy ferment. Now this challenge starts on October 5th and it goes through October 9th. Now, don't be afraid of the word challenge. It's really just to have a lot of fun. It's just to try out these recipes and post your pictures and just share with everybody and just enjoy having fun with Plan to Eat as you try to transition from a processed foods kitchen to a traditional foods kitchen. But really, no matter where you are on your journey, this is just gonna be a fun challenge. Now, there's no cost to participate in this challenge. It's just to have fun. And I'll be sure to put a link in the description below underneath this video that'll take you over to Plan to Eat, where you can sign up for the challenge. And when you sign up for the challenge, Plan to Eat's going to give you a 60-day free trial of their meal planning service. So you'll have access right away to the 6 challenge recipes that I've shared with them for you to try out and post your pictures. And then you can also start collecting other recipes that you want to add to your meal planner. And then you can create grocery lists and so on and so forth. So you have 60 days to try it out and see how you like using their meal planner. I find it very easy to use because you're gathering up recipes that you want to be in your meal planner. It's not like they're telling you, okay, today you're going to make chicken, tomorrow you're going to make fish, so on and so forth. You're gathering up the recipes that you like from around the internet or just typing in and adding your own recipes. And then you basically drag and drop those into your meal planner, and then your meal planner creates you a grocery list. And in addition to their 60-day free trial for trying out their meal planner, they've also got some surprises planned for this challenge. So be sure to head over to their website and sign up for it. I think we're going to have a lot of fun with this. And especially if you're at the beginning of your journey from a processed foods kitchen to a traditional foods kitchen. The next thing that I want to quickly share with you is something that is just so sweet. I received a note, and the front says, a sweet note. And I just thought that was so sweet because I always say sweet friends. But this note was especially special to me because this note came from a girl in college and her name is Emily. Hi, Emily. Thank you very much for this very, very lovely note. But Emily shared with me that she is very interested in, and always has been very interested in homemade foods, traditional foods. But she was a little worried about her level of skill and whatnot, but kept wanting to educate herself and learn, which I just so admire that. And she told me that the first thing that she made was cottage cheese, and it turned out well. And so she was just so happy with that. It was very cute because she wrote, "I was successful on my first attempt," with an exclamation point. So Emily, I knew you could do it. But it just warms my heart so much when I see young people, when I get comments or notes like this. They really warm my heart to show me that there are so many young people out there that are really interested in learning these traditional cooking skills, because it's so important that we teach younger people, and that so as to preserve these skills. And it's so admirable that these young people want to learn this. They really embrace it. And this was just so wonderful when I opened this, and she writes right at the very beginning, you know, that she's a university student. And that really made me happy, because I think of young women, and men for that matter, just young adults in college and wanting to learn these skills and experimenting with recipes that they may see me make or other people, you know, whatever the case may be. It's very, very encouraging. And I feel that so many of these traditional food skills are going to be preserved because of young people like Emily. So thank you again, Emily, for your lovely note. It was very sweet of you to write me, and I really appreciated it. Alrighty, now on to serious matters. Aprons. So many of you have asked me about my aprons. And so today I thought, okay, we're going to go through some of my aprons. I'm going to tell you where I got them, and or how long I've had them, and so on and so forth, and what some of my favorites are. Now, the one that I'm just wearing, this red apron, I like these solid ones. I wear ones like this a lot. These are sort of my everyday working aprons. And these I've just gotten at different places, you know. Local kitchen stores sell them in our area. Amazon sells them, you know. I love these type because they're nice, heavy, kind of almost like a sailcloth fabric. They hold up beautifully. But they're just kind of my working aprons. And I know the ones that you're interested in are more the pretty ones that I have. But the first one that I want to talk with you about is, and this is what I was holding up that was in the thumbnail, this apron is monogrammed with Mary's Nest. And this is a beautiful apron. I mean, talk about sailcloth. This apron is so thick. It's amazing. And this was sent to me as a gift from a little company here in the United States that makes aprons. And they sent this to me before everything happened here, you know, in the world with all of everything that's going on. And they had to close down their little shop, and they're finally reopened and trying to get back on their feet again. But this isn't a sponsored post. They just sent this to me as a gift, and I just wanted to show it to you because it's just such a beautiful apron. And I'll put a link to their website in the description below underneath this video. It's just a little company, and the aprons are made right here in the United States, and they can be monogrammed. And they're really, really good quality. And they come in all different colors, and you can get different things monogrammed on them. And these are, you know, just cloth neck straps and apron ties. But I think some of them you can get with leather. They have beautiful grommets. I was really impressed. And the name of the company is Koda. I think it's K-O-D-A. It's a beautiful, glorious heavyweight apron. So check them out. You know, I think that it'd be nice, you know, especially since it's just a little company and they make everything here in the United States. And, you know, it's been rough on so many small businesses here and around the world, where with everything that's going on, often many small businesses had to close their doors, as did they, but they're getting back on their feet again. And so definitely check them out and let me know what you think when you look at their website, what you think of their aprons and whatnot. But I'm very impressed. And so Koda, I want to thank you very much, Koda Company, for sending me that as a gift. It's really lovely. Now, this apron I get a lot of questions about. This is my old standby. This is a real working apron, too. I wear this a lot. And this apron, and I know so many of you said, did you make it? Where'd you get it? It is so pretty. But I have to tell you, I have had this apron since the 1980s. I bought this at a kitchen store when I lived back east. And it has held up so beautifully. This too is like got that real heavyweight sailcloth kind of fabric. And the colors have held up well, but you know, I can't even remember the name of the store. And the funny thing about it is, it was one of those like little discount stores. And it's when I lived in Washington, well, I worked in Washington, D.C., but I lived in Virginia, Northern Virginia. And there was this little store. It was kind of, for anybody who's familiar with Tuesday Morning, it was like that store, but that wasn't the name of it. It was some other, like, almost like kind of like a little junk shop that had a lot of little seconds and extras and sort of like a, maybe a Big Lots or something like that. And it was just over there in Northern Virginia, and I bought that apron there. And I have just, as I said, this is going back to the 1980s. I've had it for years. It's held up beautifully. So sometimes, you know, if you're just looking around at some of those little, you know, overstock type stores like a Big Lots or a Tuesday Morning, keep your eyes open because I have seen very lovely aprons there. And so I hope you have good luck in your travels. Next, these aprons are absolutely glorious. And those of you who know my friend Heidi, who has the YouTube channel Rain Country Homestead, she also has an Etsy shop by the same name, Rain Country Homestead. And I'll be sure to link to it in the description below. But Heidi makes aprons, and they are glorious. I love this with the cardinals. I know it's no surprise there, Mary's Nest. That I would like something with birds, but especially cardinals, because that's kind of like our family mascot. You know, it's just a bird both my husband and I love. But I will, I'll put this on, I'll take a picture of myself, and so that you can see the full glory of it, because these are beautiful. These are just, her aprons are glorious. They're like pioneer lady type aprons. They're real full. They have a beautiful skirt on the bottom. And speaking of skirts, she also makes pioneer lady skirts. I purchased this apron and another one that I have also. And then Heidi, who is so sweet, sent me one as a gift. And she sent me this one, and of course it has birds on it. And when she got this fabric, she said, oh my goodness, I know who I have to make an apron for using this fabric. And look at these sweet birds. I love this fabric. It just has, hopefully I didn't hit the mic, but it just has a beautiful vintage feel to it. And these charming little birds. But these are the kinds of aprons she makes. They always have big pockets on the bottom and then a big hem like this. They're just glorious. And this one, it's just so sweet. It's just got such a vintage, you know, I really feel like a pioneer lady in this apron. But now, if you head over to her Etsy shop and you don't see any aprons there, don't worry. The minute she puts an apron up on her Etsy shop, it sells out. So what you'll need to do is there's a place where you can contact her on Etsy and just let her know that you would like to buy an apron from her. And they're all handmade. They're just gorgeous. And then you can tell her, oh, I'd like it, you know, maybe a fabric with birds or fruit or whatever the case may be. And then she'll let you know what fabric she has that might interest you. And then she can make the apron for you based on whatever fabric you decide on. So don't worry if you head over there because they always sell out right away. And I think the same with her pioneer skirts. If you're looking for one of those, I think when she puts them up on her shop, they sell pretty quickly too. So definitely, again, if that's something you're interested in, you can, you know, contact her. But look around in her shop. She's got a lot of nice things. Her husband, Patrick, does a lot of woodworking. And so she's got pasta racks and cutting boards and all kinds of things, a little mortar and pestle and those honey dipping wooden things, honey dipper, I guess that's what it's called, but all kinds of nice things. And Heidi also makes a lot of other things other than just skirts and aprons. She makes all kinds of crocheted items. She also makes soaps. I think she might make like little chapsticks that she makes with all essential oils and whatnot. She's very, you know, very good at different types of crafts. So definitely head over, and I'll put a link to her Etsy shop in my in the description underneath this video. So definitely check that out. Now this apron I have to show you, and any of you in Texas are going to know what I'm talking about. But my husband and I were driving down to see our son. And the way that we drive, we always stop at a place called Bucky's. And if you've never been to a Bucky's, it's amazing. It's a massive store with hundreds, I think, I don't know, things to get, you know, gasoline stalls outside. And it's just for cars. It's not a truck stop. So it's really like fancy. And it is huge. When you go in, they sell so much stuff. They have all kinds of food. They have a counter just devoted to jerky. There must be 100 types of jerky. It's so Texas. They have honey that you can buy in little cowboy, you know, glass cowboy boots. They have all kinds of cowboy country stuff, knickknacks, all kinds of food. And Bucky, the symbol, is a little beaver. And he's so cute. And they have a big statue of him outside of every location. They have a big sign way up in the sky that looks like a big sun with his face on it. They sell stuffed animals of him. They sell t-shirts. It, to me, it's funny because, you know, I'm from the East Coast. And as I shared with you, you know, I'm married a Texan. And there are things in Texas that are just so Texas, you know, as my mother said, when my parents moved here a little before I did, and I remember my mother calling me up and I said, how do you like it? You know, they were New Yorkers. And she said, we love it. We're never coming back. She said, Texas is bigger and better. I thought that was so cute. And then she followed that up with, and you better believe it, you know, because I'm sure the people that she was meeting, the Texans, you know, were very proud, and they're very proud of their state, and they have every right to be, because it's just a fabulous place to live. But Bucky's is an experience. It's a destination. I mean, people come to visit Texas, and they're like, can you take me to a Bucky's? So it's a lot of fun. But in any event, they sell all kinds of stuff there. And I was with my husband, and we were going down to visit our son. And I saw this apron. And yes, it's white. And I know, oh my gosh, I don't it's good. I'm trying to keep it as clean as possible. But I loved it, again, because of the cardinal. And it's not just got the male cardinal, it's got the female cardinal. So it's like the Mr. and Mrs., the husband and wife. And I'm just an old softy romantic. And so mine makes me think of my husband and me, the two of us together here. But isn't this just the cutest thing? And I got this at Bucky's. So it just goes to show you, they sell everything and anything. But I wanted to share this with you, and I thought Texans would get a kick out of this. And if you're not from Texas, but you plan on visiting, make sure whoever you're visiting takes you to a Bucky's. And speaking of Texas, I have something very fun to share with you. If you have the radio on in your home, or you're driving in the car and you've got the radio on, and you live in the Central Texas area, be sure to turn to the Easy Listening Station 91.3 FM, because you may hear someone talking about bone broth, ferment, sourdough, and more. And the radio station 91.3 FM is KNCT, and they also have an app. So even if you don't live in Central Texas, you can listen to them anywhere. And I'm very proud to have Mary's Nest be a supporter of their radio station. So once a day, at some point during the day, they mention Mary's Nest, and they mention my website, and it's very cute. But I highly recommend that during these turbulent times, turn on the radio and listen to their wonderful channel of very relaxing, or their wonderful station of very relaxing music, or go to their app. I'll be sure to put links over on the blog post that corresponds with this video today. And be sure to enjoy listening to their music, because it's very delightful. And I'm very proud to be a supporter of the radio station. Now, the rest of the aprons that I have here are kind of just a little collection. I have some others as well, but these are primarily ones you've probably seen me wear a lot when I'm filming my YouTube videos. And this one I get a lot of questions about. This is the ladies' baker apron is what I call it. And it's just got all these wonderful things with wooden spoons and whisks and flowers and so on and so forth, bags of flour, cartons of flour. But unfortunately, I think a lot of times this one is sold out because it's just so popular and everybody likes it. But I'll be sure to put a link in the description below. I'll definitely try to find this one. This is just from Amazon. And this has actually been, it's a pretty good weight, but it's been washed a lot. So a lot of the, you know how like when aprons are very stiff, you know, the sizing, I think they call it, that's on it. This one's been washed a lot because it's gotten dirty a lot with baking. So I just found this on Amazon. And so I'll put a link below if I can find this one in stock. And I really like the aprons that I've got from Amazon. They're very reasonably priced, and they usually have, you know, they've kind of got that sailcloth feel. They're pretty heavy duty. I like this one, this sort of ocean one. In Central Texas, we have a lot of lakes, so I think this more of, you know, like the lakes than the ocean. But, and then, you know, I've got some floral ones. I've got this one with the lemons. I really like this one whenever I'm doing something with citrus. But really, yeah, for the most part, for these, I just searched for aprons on Amazon, and sometimes, you know, I'd see something like these and they'd be so pretty. So I'll see what ones I can find that are identical to these or similar, and I'll be sure to put the links in the description below. But again, like I mentioned with the one that I bought back in the 1980s, that's really held up very beautifully. Also check, you know, those little, you know, like your Tuesday Mornings or your Big Lots or whatever stores that you might have like that to see if they have aprons that are like this as well. Because I think these are pretty common. I also want to mention, now that we're in October and we've got September behind us, which was preparedness month, there are a wealth of videos out there, not just on my channel, where I'll link below to my Prepper Pantry series, but there are a wealth of videos out there for any of you who are new or experienced to prepping, so to speak, your pantry and stocking food for the long term and so on and so forth. And some of my friends have done great series of videos. And I wanted to mention that I think a lot of you know my friend Denise over at This and That with Denise. She's got a great Prepper Pantry series. Robin, my other friend Robin over at Faith and Flour, she's got a great video on stocking your pantry. And she is incredibly neat and organized and efficient. So if you really want something beautifully structured and very organized, she's really a go-to gal for that. And then the other person that I want to mention, of course, you know, I mentioned already Heidi with the aprons, but for those of you who know her, you know that it's preparedness month every month at Heidi's. So if there's any food you're wondering about how to can or how to preserve or how to keep for long-term storage, she really is the go-to gal for that. She's got so much information out there on that. And then the other person I want to mention is my friend Rob over at Ession's Family, I think it's Ession's Family Garden, yeah. And I'll put a link to that because it's unusual spelling. But he and his wife and his two boys have a great channel. And he did a video about pressure canning. But what's so interesting about that video, he takes you and shows you the pantry where his wife organizes all of her home canned goods. And it's just a really neat system because she doesn't label everything individually. She kind of has this signage system that's very clever. And so I want to link to that video. And definitely take a look at that, because if you're thinking of creative ways to store your home canned goods, they've got some good ideas over on their channel. And one other channel that I want to mention to you, and I'll put the link in the description below, is Jackie's channel. And Jackie's such a sweet friend of mine, and her channel is called Little Country Cabin. And she's got a lot of great information about how to make a lot of things homemade for your pantry. And she actually has a nice little homestead, and she has a lot of information if you're interested in, having a cow and what to do with raw dairy and how to make butter and how to make ghee and all these different things. And she's just so nice, and really her channel's relatively new, but she's got some great information over there. And I think it dovetails really beautiful with Preparedness Month, because it's a lot about making things homemade and how to store them in your pantry. And there's just one other channel that I want to share with you. And this is my friend Jennifer. And her channel is The Daily Connoisseur. And some of you may know Jennifer. Now, this is really just for fun, because this has nothing to do with pantry or prepping or anything, but I just find her so delightful. And as I said, the name of her channel is The Daily Connoisseur. And you may know her because her full name is Jennifer L. Scott, and she's a New York Times bestselling author. And she has written a line of books. I think the first one is like Lessons Learned from Madame Chic or something like that. But it's about time when she was living in France as a young woman. And now she's here and lives in the United States. And she's a mother. And I think she has four children. She's married. And she has this YouTube channel, and it's, as I said, called The Daily Connoisseur. And basically what she talks about is all the lovely things about life. She talks about nice music and fine art and lovely ways to dress modestly but pretty. And she just is very delightful, and she's just been a very sweet friend to me. And during the month of September, she kind of jumped in and into this whole preparedness month. And I think once a week, she does little assignments that she shares with her viewers, like to listen to certain kind of music or to read a nice poem, or to look at a lovely piece of art or something like that. But she was cute. For one of her weekly assignments in September, she talked about being prepared and preparing your pantry. And she was talking about me and about Denise from This and That with Denise. So I think that, during these difficult and stressful times, you can listen to 91.3 FM KNCT on your app. You can go over and get some ideas on her site about fine art to look at, or a lovely book to read, or something like that. And I think that with lovely music and some lovely art and poetry and books, we're all going to get through this. So definitely go over and visit Jennifer, and I'll be sure to put the link to her channel in the description below. So sit back, relax, listen to some nice music, get to know the Plan to Eat app, read a nice book, and when you're ready, put your apron on and click on this video over here so you can make a sweet treat to enjoy during these stressful times. And I'll see you over there in my Texas Hill Country kitchen. Love, and God bless.